Hello friends and welcome to my YouTube channel Simply Stocks, and today I'm going to talk about NBCC. Will the slider rest in this stock, and where one can buy this stock and hold for a medium term time frame? So let's get started. First of all, disclaimer that this is not a stock recommendation. People taking any position or any share that I talk about should do that with their own due diligence and research, and I'm not in favor or against any company that I talk about. Before I talk about NBCC, a small request, kindly support me on Patreon. Once you do that, it will help me grow the channel, help you also ask me questions and eke out answers in greater detail. Once you get the $10 membership, you'll have access to my portfolio, my watch list, and a number of podcasts I put up from time to time. And also, if you can pay $100 upfront, you get 1 year access by paying for 10 months, so that's a 16% discount. For detailed market or company talk, you can directly email me and we can work things out with a fee. And also, if you cannot pay on Patreon, you can join the YouTube membership and you get all the benefits of Patreon on YouTube. Now about the company, NBCC is a public sector unit and it is involved in government housing projects. It gets most of the government orders and the order book is extremely strong. The order pipeline is extremely strong at more than 80,000 crore worth of projects that are available to them over the next 5 years. It has the best return ratios and order pipeline in this domain of, you can say, affordable housing, and completely debt-free company. If you look at the numbers, these are December quarter numbers. So sales went up by, sales per flat at around 1500 crores, whereas profit dipped by 15% to 69 crores. It's a zero debt company. ROE of 15% is pretty strong, but margins have dipped to around 3.6%, which is not that strong. At the moment, there is high promoter and institutional holding, there is 24% free float, and the stock has not done exceptionally well. So let's look at how the performance has been. So the performance hasn't been that great, and the stock has fallen from the highs of around 60-68 all the way to 37-38-36. Why is it attractive at these levels? I'll just look at that. It is at very reasonable valuations at around 37 rupees. It's trading at 25 times current earnings. And if you look at forward earnings, because earnings should come through, it's trading at 21-22 times. There's sharp recovery expected on the ground over the next few months with the kind of, you can say, projects that are now unveiling after the pandemic is over. And prospects look bright for the next 12 to 18 months for the sector, as the pandemic is virtually over now and things have opened up completely. See, it may correct further from here. It may correct closer to 32, 31 levels, and those will be very attractive levels for somebody to get into NBCC. And investors are very upbeat on the housing sector. The only, you can say, problem in this in everything of this is the inflationary pressure or the cost pressure of the raw material, cement, etc., that has gone up sharply. So that is going to put a spanner into the works at the moment. But overall, looking at a scenario from a 2 to 3 year point of view, the sector looks primed for a big up move. Multiple government initiatives are in the pipeline to kickstart growth in the sector. Inflationary pressure has to go away. So for the next 3-4 months, we could see some pressure on the stock, and that's why it's prudent to probably buy into the stock at lower levels, closer to 32 or between 30 to 32 levels. If you look at technically speaking, then there is strong support around the 30 to 33 region, and that is why around 32 would be very good levels to buy into. Heavy resistance is around 42, so if one can get it around 10 to 15% lower than current levels, those will be very good levels to buy into. Have fallen 85% from the 2017 peak. In 2017, it was trading at over 100 rupees a share, so it has fallen appreciably from those levels. It may slide further, as I explained, around 15 to 18% from current levels once the market gives a correction, because the market has gone up from those 15,700 levels and probably may go to 17,800 odd levels from here on in, and then a correction would set in the middle of April. So be ready for that correction and then buy the stock when the correction is in full swing and the stock goes closer to 30 rupees, 32 rupees That would be the levels to buy into. Currently, it is looking weak on charts, but support lies around those 30 region, and it will surge once 42 is taken out, and the next level could be closer to 60. And that's why the returns here could be very sharp, quick, and big returns in the stock of more than 50, 60, 80% in a few months if one can time the entry and exit well. So what needs to be done can be looked at these levels as well, and on declines to 32 levels, and add on major declines closer to 30 or around 32, 33 levels. If you have it, then hold on to the stock. Have 2 to 3 year time frame. I think it should break out on the upside. If you have a 3 year time frame, I won't be surprised if you look at the stock at around 80, 85 levels over the next 3 years. So this is my video on NBCC. Please like and subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon so you can get my videos straight away when I post it, and kindly support me on Patreon. Thanks a lot for watching.